Hi, everybody. It's Coach Vin and myself. How you doing, Coach?
Good. How you doing, Coach?
Good. Today is the first day of our winter youth league drill series. So over the course of 10 weeks, we are going to take 10 different drills, although there'll be more than 10 drills, but 10 different areas of drilling youth league players. And the type of player this is built for, ages 9 to 12, intermediate player, players who are playing in local youth leagues, not necessarily travel ball, but all some really basic fundamental things that whether you're a travel ball player or a youth league player, they'll be effective for you. They're going to help your game. So that's where we start today. And today we actually start with securing the ball.
Yep.
All right. So catching the baseball, specifically ground balls, and just a five sequence drill series to help kids kind of stay on time, not rush, make sure their footwork is good, and then make sure they're seeing the ball into their glove, just like we tell them to see the ball to the bat. It's the same thing in the infield. So, ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
Let's do it. Drill number one in our defensive drill series for intermediate players, right? Really simple, and again, this is for kids ages, you know, anywhere from 7 years old to 12 years old. So I have a set of cones here, and the reason they're here is to help me catch the ball out in front of my face. And we also want to make sure that our young infielders, when they go to catch the ball, you know, they open the glove. So there should be a slight bent back position of the wrist. So if the glove's not on my hand, right, I'm here with it, I'm showing it. And I'm just going to use one hand, my glove hand. I'm going to take the other hand, just kind of lay it behind my back. Coach Vin is behind the camera. He's going to roll the ball to me. And nice and simple, I'm going to reach out. I'm going to catch it out over the cones, secure the ball, and the thing you're really going to see me do is take my eyes right to the glove, and I'm going to hold it for just a second. Right? You can see if I had a hat on, you can see the top of my cap, you can see the top of my head. Right? So we're going to do a set of five or six. Ready, Coach?
I'm ready.
And I'm just going to hold it for two. And it forces your young infielders, your young catchers, to see the ball to their glove. Two more. Okay. Go to the second drill. So it's almost the exact same thing. Okay, this time I'm going to take my other hand out, and now I'm going to catch the ball with two hands. And again, this is designed to help them see the ball to the glove. Okay, we're not going to do this in the field, but for, again, for young infielders who are just learning to play the infield, again, seeing the ball to the glove is key. Okay, so now I'm going to bring the second hand in, and if you watch my hands, they're not going to be one over the other. All right, they're going to be at about 2 o'clock and 8 o'clock if you have the hands on the clock. Ready, Coach?
Ready.
Same thing. Third drill. So those are our first two. After I'm still on my knees, after I catch the ball, I'm going to receive it with two hands. I'm going to stand up. I'm a right-handed thrower. So I'm going to stand up, and when I stand up, it's going to be left foot first and then right foot out. Okay, so when I flip the ball, I want to flip it off of my throwing side foot. So it's left-right when I stand up and flip. Coach Vin is behind the camera. So when I do this, and again, for young players, they like doing this. After I catch the ball, I stand up, left, right, I flip it to him. I'm going to follow the flip. I'm going to give Coach Vin a high five. COVID country right now, I'm actually going to give Coach an elbow.
Yep.
But when we're able to get back to normal, kids love to give high fives. If you're a young coach, make them stand up and give you a high five. And anytime you flip the ball, you want to make sure they follow their flip and they use their body weight and their body lean to actually generate the power of the flip. Okay, Coach, you ready?
Ready.
Yep.
Perfect, Coach.
Thanks. Feeling good today?
Yeah, it looks good.
Feeling good. drill four. So this time, we're going to get off of our knees. And the reason we're starting on our knees, it helps young infielders stay in place. So sometimes their feet get happy, you move them, they don't stay behind the ball, it forces them to lock in place. And now, I've been on my knees for the last 15 balls that I've received. Now I'm going to get up into a good ground ball position. So I can take, if you're on the field, or if you're inside somewhere, and you have young players, you want them to get down low enough, you can put a chair right behind them. Right? And when they sit, they want to feel their butt just touching the back rim, the front rim of the chair, right? So I'm going to get down in my ground ball stance. I'm nice and low. All right, I can feel myself touching. I'm going to catch the ball out over the cones. And again, I'm going to flip it back to Vinny. All right, coach.
Good workout, coach.
No, I'm starting to breathe heavy, man. That's what happens when you get a little older. Drill five. We're going to do the exact same thing, except you can incorporate another teammate receiving the ball to the left. So I'm going to receive the flip. You're going to see me cross over with my right foot and flip the ball there. There's no player there, so I'm just going to flip it there, but you'll see my body. And these are five drills that, again, just designed to help young players secure the ball. And as you're seeing, I'm hesitating just for a second before I go anywhere. Right? I'm catching the ball, bringing my eyes to the glove, making sure I'm seeing the ball before I do the action. And eventually, you get to some ground balls, you're rolling ground balls on the field for kids. They're playing through it, without stopping, but you'll start to notice they start getting in the habit of glove out front, seeing the ball with the glove, moving their feet, staying low. Okay, all really important parts of playing the infield. All right, Ben, you ready? We got five more?
I'm ready.
Okay. Coach Vinn, thank you. Thank you for rolling, helping with it. Five simple drills and there's a million of variations you can do off of this, but those are just five that, for a young youth league player, the two basic things here, catching the ball out front, making sure the angle of the wrist is good, and really tracking the ball to your glove, which most young infielders need to do, but as well as sitting, getting low into your hips, it's hard for kids not really. They're not strong enough to do it most of the time, but at least if you can get them to do a couple reps, it makes a huge difference with how they pick up the ball. So you played at a pretty high level, college baseball, professional baseball, your first baseman. Simple drills where we're rolling the ball. How much of that did you guys do in college, professional baseball?
We did it every day. So when we started practice, we started with work just like this, and we worked on it for 45 minutes to start practice. That's before we even touched a baseball off the bat, before we even threw. That was the first thing we did. We did drills just like Coach Bill just did, and it does show up in the field. So if you're not doing the drill work, it will definitely show in the game. Coach Delaney and Skip were big on that in Quinnipiac, which is where I went. Every day you had to come in, focus, and do the small things, because the small things matter.
And for youth league players, when you get to be that age, same thing in college for myself, the professional baseball, and even as a college coach, we had the New Haven Ravens playing in Yale Field, and Double A.
Yep.
And I remember the manager coming out, and they had a new second baseman come up, and for literally 30 minutes, and he had a screen behind him, like taking the second baseman, they were converting him, and just rolling him ground balls over on Double A field, Double A level. So the interesting part of this is that at the high levels, we spend a lot of time rolling the ball. At the younger levels, travel baseball, there's a lot of good units out there. There's a lot of really good groups out there that are teaching the game. I know with our guys, we roll a lot of ground balls, talk about a lot of simple, fundamental things. As a youth league manager, coach, that's maybe non-travel, you know, you're in one of the local town leagues, you know, being able to roll the ball and just kind of set it up like this, you'll be amazed if you do it over the course of a season. Pre-game, you know, you're creating your stations. You could have each of the stations that we just did, it's 15 minutes, and that takes you 15 minutes. You got five awesome drills if you got five dads to help with it, and it's 15 minutes. And obviously, you get all this infield work done. It's a great pregame warm-up piece to catch the ball. Awesome. So this is our first drill series. Five simple drills you can use in practice. Hopefully it helps. If you guys need any help at all, please don't hesitate to contact us here at the Core Training Academy. I know all the local leagues, you guys know we are. A lot of your kids are in, but we're here to help in terms of, coach development, player development. Okay? Coach, thank you very much.
That's what we do here.
That's what we do.
Thank you, bro.